Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2458, Changing Excel's 2029 Rule. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today, a note from John G., who is very frustrated. He retires on January 1st, 2030, and every time he tries to enter a date, like 1/1/30, a two-digit year, it's giving him a date in 1930. This is known as the 2029 Rule, and when they set this up, you know, back when we were all worried about Y2K, it was probably a fine rule. It was 30 years away, but we're getting closer now. It'd be nice to be able to bump that date. Like if we entered 29 or 30 or 31, then it would be 2030 or 2031. Microsoft documents on how to fix this, but it is a horrible help article. It's taken me 3 days to figure out what they're talking about. Start settings, control panel, regional settings icon. Now I'm back in Windows 10. I don't have that. So start. Click the little gear wheel here. That gets me in. There's nothing here that says regional settings. There's this that says time and language region. All right, then I click on region. Then I come over here to additional date, time, and regional settings. Change date, time, or number formats. Nothing here. Additional settings. Nothing here. Oh, there's tabs across the top. Date. That's where it is. Right, so right here I bumped mine up to 2049. That'll give me another 20 years. So anything from 50 to 99 will be 1900s. Anything from 1 or 0 up to 49 will be 2049. You can adjust this however you'd like. All right, so if you're worried about this 2029 rule, the setting is there in Windows 10. It's kind of hard to find. That's the steps. Check out my new courses on retrieve. If you like these videos, please down below, like, subscribe, and ring the bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the comments below. Well, hey, I want to thank John for sending that question in. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel. Let's hear you, Nancy.